Oke, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning everyone. Thanks to the organizer 2020 IEEE International Conference on Automatic Control and Intelligent Systems I2CACIS2020. Today, we would like to present our works entitled Self-Monitoring and Detection of Diabetes with Smart Toilet based on Image Processing and K-Means Technique. My name is Amrul Farouk here. On behalf of my supervisor, Dr. Insinyur Lailus Syafa'ah from Faculty of Engineering, Universitas Muhammadiyah Malang, Indonesia, and also I am a graduate student from Malaysia Japan International Institute of Technology, University of Technology Malaysia, Kuala Lumpur. We start with background of this study about diabetes mellitus. Diabetes mellitus or DM is a metabolic issue described as hyperglycemia or high glucose that is progressively affecting the world population. There are four non-communicable diseases can cause the highest death. One of them is diabetes mellitus. The other three, such as disease, namely cancer, blood vessels, and heart, also has a hypertension, and heart disease may also be caused by diabetes. Currently, the number of diabetics in the world is around 200 million and is expected to increase to 350 million in 2030. Especially in Indonesia, more than 7 million people had diabetes in 2012, and 80% they didn't know that they had diabetes. Our motivations today is due to advanced IoT-based technology has been developed and demonstrated by the researchers, including in healthcare application. And urine analysis samples and color level indicator can be used for early detection of diabetic complication, according to D.G. Newman in 2005. And developing urine analyzer and advanced IoT-based technology is very interesting application for medical problems, especially for diabetes. It is according to Budianto 2018. Urinary assessment and culture is very important to track infection for its patients. The basic idea about this work is to detect and monitor urine color based on image processing. How it works? It starts with we have patient with diabetes. For sure, we have a toilet at home. From the toilet at home, we can detect urine color based on the RGB red, green, blue color to detect whether this color have represent correlated with diabetes patient or normal patients. From the color detection, we can also monitor by apps or mobile phone. From this research, we address two research questions. The first one is how to detect and monitor urine color based on image processing. The second one is how to cluster urine image processing using K-means algorithm for diabetics. The objectives of this study, number one is to detect and monitor urine color based on image processing, and the second one is to analyze urine image clustering using K-means algorithms. designing an IoT-based technology for urine color image processing. How it works? We have developed a design IoT-based technology for urine color image processing for diabetic patients. This smart toilet is designed with a prototype that uses a white background to get maximum exposure to urine from the camera. This system will generate a reading output that is displayed on the web, and also we can access from the mobile phone. The process performed to make this smart toilet can be seen from the block diagram in figure 1 as illustrated. Hardware and software design. The first, there will be a camera to detect the difference in urine color which is accumulated in the toilet. Urine as a medium that digital image processing will identify. In addition, a microcontroller, we use a Raspberry Pi to process the data and to control the system. After that, the data will be provided to the user, which can be viewed on the remote interface or web monitoring. This is how data collect and processing using K-means. The first one, we do data collection. The data collected in this study is to use to obtain the urine of a person with diabetes and in the urine of a normal person. There was 12 data samples has been carried out in this study. The data contains 10 samples with diabetic patients and 10 samples with normal patients. And next, we go through data pre-processing. Pre-processing data is a step to separate data based on the type of data. In this study, data are available in the form of number obtained from the RGB value of the urine. Data will be processed for clustering based on the predetermined value of two clusters, which is diabetes urine and normal urine. The data will be divided into 80% for training and 20% for testing. This is testing, 20%, and the last process is data processing. Data processing with clustering method is done using K-means. To do clustering using K-means, the following steps are required. First, we determine the desired number of clusters. In this study, the cluster is divided into two, in which the urine of normal people and the urine of diabetic people. The next one is determine the initial center point of the cluster or the centroid. We choose the K from randomly. From random data to determine the centroid cluster. Its data is measured by the distance to the centroid and grouping between the distance and data and the centroid cluster. This is the result based IoT based design of smart toilet. We can see in table 1. Table 1 is result of clustering number and centroid. We have grouped into two clusters, which is the number one is for patient with diabetic with diabetes, and null or zero is a cluster for people with a normal patients. And table 2 is the result of clustering and RGB urine data. We have measured the RGB value from the urine. We have RGB value and C1, C2 for the clustering, centroid clustering, and the minimum distance. The result cluster as can be seen in table 2. And from the IoT results, we have a measure calculation by some equation for clustering, and also we do automatic measure by our IoT system. And the remark is compared with IoT measure and calculation. We can see in figure 2 the clustering chart result. Sample of data obtained 80% of the total data used as training and 20% used as test data. The results of the clustering diagram obtained as shown in figure 2, the red color indicates normal urine, while the blue color indicates diabetes urine and yellow color as a centroid or middle value. This is our prototype we have developed. We called smart toilet. We have a camera inside the toilet, and also we have a monitoring and control system. This is a microcontroller. We use a Raspberry Pi, and this dashboard, internet or web-based monitoring, you can access from the website, smart mobile phone as well. Finally, we have a conclusion and future works. The conclusion for this work. First is smart toilet to detect diabetes is successfully performed using a prototype toilet and certain components such as high-end Raspberry version along with the program. In the study, clustering using K-means method was carried out successfully, namely the clustering of diabetic urine and normal urine. For future works in advance, a smart toilet should detect the urine of diabetics. Needed several parameters so that the result obtained are more accurate. And the last one is toilet lighting must be stable so that the sensor readings can be accurate. In addition to the detection of diabetes by the use of urine, patient should also be subject for further tests by the doctor or may also be monitored by the doctor. Thank you everyone for giving us a chance for this conference. This is our reference. And lastly, thank you and Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.